Great question from Pamela. How do you determine your teacher's salary? Well, if you think about a preschool teacher, what options do they have to go teach, right? They can't go teach in the school district because they don't have the certification, and so they could be like an aide, or they could be like a helper or things like that, or a volunteer, but they can't get anywhere near what a teacher could actually make because they can't teach actually in the school district. What about if they could work at a daycare? That's probably where most of the people are working currently, because there aren't a lot of strictly a preschool programs like the ones that I've created and all my preschool owners have created that are big enough to hire teachers. I mean, most of the people that are starting their own preschools, they're doing it just for their own home. It's their home preschool, they're the owner, the director, the teacher, the one-woman show, and that's about all it ever will be for them. And that's totally fine. It gives them a supplemental or full-time income, and it's perfect for them, right? But like, what about the people who want to grow and actually want to hire preschool teachers? How much should you pay them? And also, where are you going to find them, right? That's another huge one. So whenever you're thinking about where could they work, they can't work in the school district, but they're probably working currently either in a daycare setting, teaching preschool perhaps, or even just literally being a childcare provider in the daycare. Or they have maybe started their own home daycares at one point, or they are working at Head Start. That's another huge place where preschool teachers are in. And sometimes you're gonna find ones that are actually just preschool teachers in a preschool only setting, but very rarely, okay? And those ones usually will never leave because they love it so much, right? Hey, quick question. Are you ready to jump right in and get your preschool started? Oh my gosh, let's go. I would love to invite you to join our Preschool All-Stars. It's my exclusive membership community where you'll be surrounded by hundreds of preschool owners on the same journey as you, starting, running, and growing your preschools. Not to mention, I'm in there answering your questions and giving you support and cheerleading as well. It's the one place you want to be online. Now, also, when you join our Preschool All-Stars, you'll have access to our extensive library of done-for-you files, step-by-step videos, and all of my systems. That's right, you get access to those as a Preschool All-Star member. I can't wait for you to join us. Simply click the link in the description or go to preschoolallstars.com and we'll see you in there. Now, what are you waiting for? Let's go! Come join Preschool All-Stars today. Some of my best teachers actually came from Head Start, because when they're at Head Start, they're fed up with the drama. That's actually in a completely different video, so you guys can go watch that one, but they're fed up with the drama, they're fed up with the, you know, the everybody, all the families, they got a lot going on, okay, I'll just leave it right there. And there's drama with the families, the teachers, the staff, just everything is a lot, and it's a lot to handle. It's a lot of paperwork. It's a lot of kiddos who have some very difficult situations that are just pretty challenging, honestly, to have in a classroom with so many children in the classroom as well. So they're dealing with big class sizes and all these things. And so when they come see and they see my ad for like preschool teacher, that's just 2.5 hours and 12 kiddos or 6 kiddos or whatever your class size will be, it's like heaven to them. Like, oh my gosh, and this is strictly a preschool program. They're not with me all day. Like, I can just do my very best for 2.5 hours and then they go home. Like, awesome, right? And these are the people that you're looking to draw into your preschool program. So if you actually want to find out more about how to hire teachers and like which ones you're looking for and where to find them, that's a completely different video. But this one is all about how much should you pay them. But when you're, the reason I go into like where can you find them is because that's going to also dictate how much you should pay them. So you want to look at your Head Start. You want to look at the other daycares, posts. You want to find out like, okay, so I would literally go to Craigslist right now and I would search, or any other job service like Indeed, I-N-D-E-E-D.com, and search for a preschool teacher in your area and find all the posts that come up. And it's going to tell you how much other places are paying their preschool teacher. Most of them are going to say things like DOE, depending on experience, right? And it's gonna be like, oh, that's frustrating, right? And you actually have to give them a call or something like that. Sometimes you'll actually find places that list the hourly rate for their preschool teacher. It's very rare for you to also find like preschool teacher, because most places are looking for like childcare worker or daycare provider or things like that. And so, but if you do come across the preschool teacher, that's like literally the thing that you're trying to find, right? When I was choosing how much to pay my preschool teachers, I did that exact same search that I just told you to do. And then I said, okay, most of the people who ever want to be a preschool teacher are literally going to be going to get a job at a daycare or a Head Start, and they're gonna get paid about $8 to $9 per hour. Like, that's hardly nothing, right? And so if I can pay them a significant amount more than that, but not out of control, of course they're not only gonna just wanna come to me, but they're gonna stay with me too, because I'm paying way more than any other role and job they could ever get anywhere else in my area. So places that are paying $8 to $8.50, that is literally what I found in my area for a preschool teacher or somebody with my qualifications that I was looking for, and I paid them $12 an hour, okay? Significantly more, almost $4 more in some situations, okay, over what they could get anywhere else. But that still worked with my numbers because I had such good numbers. And if you follow my system, you'll be able to get good numbers like that. My system of, you know, how to structure your classes, how do you actually make sure that you charge enough so that you can hire a teacher. I was actually talking to Anita, one of my preschool owners, and she's like, I really want to hire a teacher, but I don't know if I can afford it. And I said, oh, Anita, I've got the perfect like equation for you. I said, do you have your, you know, calculator handy? She's like, yeah. And I'm like, awesome. Okay, so here's the deal, Anita. How much are you going to charge? Okay, and we're going to give like generic numbers here just so that it's easy for people's for math, right? Okay, and I said, okay, how much are you gonna charge a student? And she's like, $100, okay? Maybe it's 150, maybe it's 300, who knows what it is for you, but she's gonna charge $100 for a class. And I was like, awesome, okay, so how many students can you have in that class? She said 12, okay? So that technically, that class is worth $1,200, right? If she fills it, okay? Awesome, so you could make up to $1,200. I said, how much are you planning on paying your teacher? And she was figuring out the math, okay? And I have a calculator right in front of me and I'm gonna do this math with you, okay? And so I was saying, okay, well, if you paid her, I think she actually wanted to pay her like $15 an hour. I said, if you pay her $15 an hour, then, cause some areas are different, right? Some areas they pay more, right? So if you pay her $15 an hour, how many hours is she gonna be with you, right? And she's like, well, it's a 2.5 hour class and it's only for 2 days a week. So we're gonna do the math on that. So you do 2.5 times 2 days a week, right? So that's 5 hours a week she's teaching. And then you're gonna times that by how many weeks? 4 weeks. That's 20 hours total that teacher is working in the school. So you're gonna pay her for 20 hours. And how much are you gonna pay her? $15 an hour. So 20 times 15 is $300. Now, here's where this math comes in. I said, okay, if you have to pay her $300, then how many students do you have to get into the class to at least break even? She's like, oh, no brainer, 3 students, right? Because $100 each. I know, I'm getting you with the math, but follow me here. So if she has 3 students at $100 each, she can pay for that teacher like that, okay? Maybe 4 students to pay for the supplies and other things that the teacher would want and things like that. But if she can have 4 students, she has a very good comfortable buffer there. And anything above that is pure profit for her. So do you see how you do this? In order to hire a teacher, you say, okay, I need to get at least X amount of students in my preschool class, and anything above that is money in the school's pocket or my pocket or your income or however it works. And that's how you can figure out how much to pay a teacher. You go look at all the other places, how much they're charging, how much they're paying for their preschool teachers, and then you make sure that your income is correct, all your numbers are right, you're charging enough for your preschool classes, and that's a whole other thing I cover in Preschool in a Box, about how much to actually, you know, you go look at your competition, how much I charge, things like that. And then you're gonna be able to find out how many students do I need to enroll so I can pay for the teacher and then still get income above that. So she has the potential to get between $800 to $900 with her preschool and having a teacher and her not doing anything other than just running the show. How awesome would that be, right? And that's per class. That's where the beauty comes in when you're thinking about growing, is because all you do is just multiply that. Okay, if I had a classroom, right? Sweet, that's one teacher. If I did one class, what if I did 4 classes in that one classroom? What if I added another classroom and did another teacher with another 4 classes? And all of a sudden your income starts going up. So that's the beauty of being able to hire teachers, is you can grow your preschool and obviously grow your income as well. So my question to you is, in your area, post in the comments below, how much are people paying for preschool teachers in your area, or daycare workers or things like that? Post in the comments below, or Head Start teacher, post in the comments. And if you are a preschool teacher, post in the comments as well how much you are making. So if this was helpful to you, be sure to subscribe, share, and like. I'd love to get more videos like this into your YouTube feed so that you can continue to be able to grow your preschool and have a wonderful experience. And I'm here to help you.